The very beginning of what happened. I first created my YouTube channel in January 29th, 2012, and I named it Mr. Shy Guy 700. I was in the fourth grade at the time. I uploaded two cringy videos on my channel, but then later on in 2013, I logged off my YouTube channel, and from there on, I did not know the account details. Keep in mind, I was only like 11 when I logged out and forgot about the channel. Now you know when I started YouTube, let's talk about what moved me on forward. In March 10th, 2014, when I was 12 years old, I created another YouTube channel called HowSeal700. And this is where things get interesting. The channel I created again was not like a gaming channel, you see, it was more like a real life vlogging channel. Because in my first YouTube channel, I uploaded my first video with my 10-year-old voice, and I got the idea for my new channel to just vlog only. But that wasn't how it was going to be. This is what really changed me. In May 25th, 2014, now that 2 months have passed by, I got introduced by a game called Geometry Dash. It was my cousin that showed me this game. I didn't know much about the game because, you know, it's on the App Store and Steam. And to me, I thought those kinds of games keep you playing for a little while and then you stop playing it because they are boring later on. But that's what I thought for Geometry Dash. Till I started playing it. Playing Geometry Dash was phenomenal for me. I didn't know this game would have such an impact in my life. When I first played it, I wanted to start from the hardest to easiest, and the first level I ever played was Can't Let Go. It seemed that I didn't want an easy challenge, so I just played that level for as long as I could. Even though I beat the level ever since, I would still beat it again, and again, and again. I would then continue forward to next challenges so I could get more better at the game. Because I can't just play the level, Can't Let Go all the time. Otherwise, it wouldn't be fun anymore and just boring. Whenever I get back from school, I would go straight into playing Geometry Dash, and sometimes I would play during school time as well. I like playing during lunch, and when there isn't work in class, I would just get my iPad or phone and start playing it. It gives me nostalgia talking about this topic because whenever I think about Geometry Dash, I only remember not just the gameplay, but the music too. I was in 7th grade at the time, and mainly the game makes you rage, like rage quit. That's what makes some people not play the game anymore. But I was one of the people that didn't stop playing. Thank you. What you're seeing here is a dead collab between me and Mega Man. It was on my part that I didn't want to do it anymore. So anyway, into the next year in May 2015, I was very, very hooked in this game, and I started uploading videos to EveryPlay so I can show everyone what I have done in the game. Here are some clips of them. Lots of fun moments were made when I beat levels, and it made me want to keep playing the game more. What made me do collabs was this. I uploaded a level called Classical to Geometry Dash. Then I uploaded it to my YouTube channel. This is what I didn't expect. A person named Geometry Dash Yura commented on my classical video and asked if we could do a collab. I did respond and said, let's do it. Now while texting in an app called Kick, we both had a connection. It looked like we were known to be online friends, but I thought to myself that I would just do this one collab he asked, and after that, I would never ever talk to him again. But that wasn't the case. We still kept texting, and before you guys say, oh, you asked about your info to each other. No, we just kept it to ourselves as far as I remember because it was so long ago back in early 2015. So after that happened, I was still open for new collabs at the moment I collabed with Yura. But this time, I was only going to collab with my in real life friends because they knew Geometry Dash and so did I. But they weren't up for it when I asked, so I just kinda gave up on the collabing thing. I was then looking for creator contests to enter because I still had that mood of collaborating with people. But since my real life friends didn't want to do it, I just then wanted to collab with an online person. When I looked up Geometry Dash Creator Contest, a bunch of results came up. Now of course, the popular Geometry Dash people hosted them and lots of people joined. So chances were that you would have won, but wouldn't have. I remember one of the rewards of being a collaboration prize, and I was so gassed. But then I knew it would have taken the best skill to compete for the prizes. When I saw other results, I was looking for a contest that not many people entered in, but quite a bunch did. The person was named Geomania Dasher at the time, and this was also in 2015, but late 2015. I commented on his creator contest video that I'm going to join, and he said, yay, just remember to put GM in the level that you will enter with in the creator contest only if it's a mega collaboration. And so it begins. Collabs were going to start, especially the mega collab for the creator contest. Me playing Geometry Dash was still happening, but it then goes from creating. The game became more and more interesting as time passed because of updates. I started doing collabs in 1.9, but when 2.0 update was released, I was even more hooked. When I joined the creator contest, 2.0 was released at the time. I then asked Yura if he was down, and of course, he was. But the thing is that we needed more than two people collaborating on the level, so that it can be a mega collab for the creator contest. He then asked his other friends if they would like to join, and so they did. Keep in mind, it has been so long since this was happening, and I don't know if this part was really true, but I know for a fact that the mega collab level we made was a banger. We named it Crimson Dungeon, and it was made on November 11th, 2015. When we all finished, I was the only person to verify the level, and it took me, let's say, a long time. You know what? Let's change it up a bit. After I verified the level, I then uploaded it to my Geometry Dash account and entered it into the creator contest forums. The results won't come up until Geomania uploads the results. Me and Yura and the other collaborators that were involved in the Mega Collab were hoping we at least get second place. Then, when Geomania uploaded the results, it was the first thing I checked when I was in school. I then checked the description for the winners, and I was in shock. Me and Yura and the other collaborators got first place. I was so happy that me and the others won. This was the first creator contest I have ever entered and won. One of the prizes was an intro made for you for the person who has verified it and uploaded it. I always wanted an intro so that I can use it for every time I beat a level. I have an intro with it and uploaded it to YouTube. Now, after I was so happy that me and the others won first place, it still kept me going to play other levels because when I saw other results from the creator contest, I was so amazed that levels became more better and better from creators, and this is what still kept me beating levels in the game. Levels were a part of my Geometry Dash journey. I wanted to beat all the levels in the game, but of course, it took time. I'm talking about the main levels, not the online ones. When I completed all the main levels, I then wanted to go for the online levels and beat as many as I can. I have beaten levels that were nostalgic for me. It still gives me motivation to beat levels in the game mainly because of the music that I like. I then beat demon levels that push me forward into beating more and more harder ones. I then proceed forward in the game. Now, during the time when I was still playing Geometry Dash every day, I was starting to get more and more and more addicted to it. This led me to not pay attention to other important things, such as being with my family, friends, and other things that is a part of my life besides games. This now led me to be more lazy in life as before. I didn't want anything to do with my family, friends, my relationship with God, and other important stuff. Geometry Dash was now taking up my time to focus in school, finish homework, and do other life activity things. I was thinking in my mind, wait, this will lead me nowhere in life. If I'm too addicted to something, then why keep going if it will do no good to yourself? My addiction into playing Geometry Dash was still getting worse and worse, and I was afraid of telling my parents that I'm addicted to a game because I didn't want to get in trouble. But don't they see me addicted to Geometry Dash? Well, yes, but I tell them that I don't play as much and I focus on other things like school, friends, and life itself. But it was clearly a lie to fool them that I'm actually not playing so much. But I'm clearly playing a lot. During the years I have passed through, like 2014 through 2017, I was trying to avoid people who are bad influences. I'm friends with the people that play Geometry Dash with me in real life, and some that were just people online. I'm going to be honest, I had more online friends than real life friends, and this was because I didn't like the people's personalities that I talked to. Like, for example, in schools, they have convictions that are dumb, and in groups, their personas do not interest me because of how they act and what they choose. Now, I know that my online friends don't share their thoughts and convictions, but that is because we all knew that we would start arguing, and eventually split apart online friendships. I had arguments with Yura and others. Of course, it was dumb, but we sorted things out. Forget the past and leave it behind and just move on forward. That's pretty much what it has been going through in my mind, and probably my online friends too. Whenever I play Geometry Dash by myself, I just distance myself from fake people that would try to ruin me. I don't wish them that they have bad lives, but I pray to God that they change the way they are. Before I say my achievements, I also want to add something to this topic. I created a channel on August 24th, 2014 that was originally called Jigglypuff from Pokemon, but instead, I called it Chef Pee-Pee. Now I know what you're thinking, why call it that name? Well, if you don't know, Chef Pee-Pee is a character name that is from Super Mario Logan, and I would just comment on his videos with the channel and say things that are relevant to the video. Like, for example, I said, Junior's so annoying, and why is this happening, and etc. I would gain a lot of subscribers and replies from the comments I made on Super Mario Logan's videos. I got 4,000 subscribers and I was so shocked because I told people, why even subscribe to a channel that is not the real character and just makes comments on a popular YouTube channel? This was an achievement to me. I then made a video on the channel and titled it, Chef Pee Pee Will Advertise You. And 10,000 people watched it and fell for it because it was simply bait for people to subscribe to a channel that was the owner of it. That was me owning the channel, and I put in the description that you should subscribe to Geometry Dash SL 700, and I went from 14 to 60 subscribers in a day. I then kind of felt bad because I fooled people to subscribe to my channel and I wanted to have all the subscribers, and this is the part when I became stingy. After people have subscribed to Chef Pee Pee, there were almost 5,000 people subscribed. I then made a confession video on my Chef Pee Pee channel, and people were mad, but some were not. I admitted that I fooled the ones who watched the video to subscribe to my Geometry Dash channel, and I just wanted subscribers. I then changed the Chef Pee Pee channel name to my Geometry Dash SCL 700 channel name. People then unsubscribed, and I honestly don't know why I changed it. I remember either I was not caring about my channel name anymore, or I wanted to look like I have a bigger channel than my friends. Later on, I started to upload Geometry Dash videos, and some videos gained more views than on my other channel. But I was starting to just change it back to Chef Pee Pee because it wasn't right and people started to subscribe back. Now in January 2019, I then deleted Chef Pee Pee. People were wondering, why did you do it? And I just didn't answer them because I was not in the mood. But there was a reason why I deleted it. The reason is because I wanted to start off fresh and leave that past behind me. I know it was a lot of subscribers, but numbers didn't really matter to me. I brought this channel up because I want to let you guys know that you should never be stingy because of numbers and never be envious because of people being better than you. Now that's out of the way, I made a lot of achievements in Geometry Dash. Beating levels that were really tough had built my skill. Also, in creating levels and collaborations as well. In April 21st, 2016, I watched a Geometry Dash livestream and RobTop was in it. You know, the creator of Geometry Dash. I messaged him in a Twitch chat and I told him this. He responded with a Kappa emote and I was shocked and surprised because I didn't think he would message me at a time like that, especially since a lot of people were also messaging him too. People asked RobTop to rate their levels and feature them. It was rare back then that you had your level rated and featured by him. I then asked RobTop if he could rate my level, Blue Moon, and possibly feature it since it was an unfinished level by Mindsap. And so he did. He rated my level with stars and verified coins, but no feature. My reaction was indescribable. I was screaming like a little girl on the inside, and my heart was pumping 10 times faster than heart levels I have ever beaten. This was the best achievement I've ever made in my life so far. This was counted as one of my goals in the game. I then proceeded to beat more and more demon levels in the future, and I knew it was still a long way. but I don't care how much I rage. As long as I complete something, that's all that matters. Also, in October 2016, I was making a series involving Jamshedash people in the community, and I named the series Jamshedash Hasil 700 Adventures. I made it like a leafy type video, but of course, with Jamshedash involved. Now you might be thinking, how is this an achievement? I counted this series as an achievement because I learned more advanced editing for my future videos and the series. I knew this was going to help me when I edit my Jamshedash videos. If it wasn't for the series I had thought of, I would have slacked on editing and being original for myself. The Jamshedash Hasil 700 Adventures series was planned to still keep going, as I have uploaded my 3 years playing Jamshedash video. As you can see, I was planning a movie to be in the works. It would have been achievements if I made these future videos, and it would have been a part of my Geometry Dash legacy. But I just didn't think it was going to be great. Also, in January 17th, 2017, I uploaded a Geometry Dash level montage from levels 1 to 21 because 2.1 was released at the time. I was expecting to get at least 10,000 views, but I thought wrong. My video was growing so fast in views and the like/dislike ratios were pretty normal. I gained over 140,000 views in 1 year on my Geometry Dash channel, and you may be asking, why did I delete my channel and the others as well? I'm starting off fresh and new in my first channel I ever made. When I had that much views on the montage video, I was very happy because I have never uploaded a video that gets a lot of views in a whole year. Thank you all so much. I don't know what I can say, but I hope you guys smile when I start to make more videos soon. During my Jamshedash legacy, I was encountering struggles as I grew older and older when time passes by. I hit a point when I was just burnt out and had depression. This was serious stuff I had back then. While I was burnt out, I didn't want to make videos anymore and also didn't want to play Jamshedash anymore. I thought about quitting because it was just getting boring and not fun anymore. How I got depression was my supposed friend from a school I have been through and despised for the longest time that told me I was worthless and I should kill myself. I honestly thought about killing myself because of what he said. This all started in 2016 and I was friends with him because I thought he was a good friend, but since he threatened the school to like bomb the place, you shouldn't even say that even though it's all jokes. I then told Yura about the situation and he told me to just report him to the school office. My heart was crumpling like a piece of paper because I had never been through a situation like this before. He is a fake friend I had. After 8th grade was over, he left the school and never came back. But he told me that if I ever snitch on him again, then see what would happen. He knew about the report I said about him. I have never ever had this strange feeling in my life before, and it was good to do what is right and to be the bigger person. This is why he told me I was worthless and that I should kill myself. I hope you will understand what I just said and why I was feeling suicidal. You may be asking, why do you despise the school you went through? Well, I just see some people there as fake ones that wear a mask to hide their true colors. I wear the shy guy mask to hide my face, not to hide my true colors. Trust me, I am not a fake person, nor will ever be one. I will never threaten people just because if they ever reported me for something I have done. That is just not me. I pray to God that he does well, even though he made me feel suicidal and worthless, because words can hurt people's feelings. I want to say this to the people who are feeling suicidal or having a problem with their lives. Never listen to those who put you down, because all the ones who have told you bad stuff will want you to suffer for the rest of your lives. Don't ever let anyone put you down, and stand up for yourself, because suicide will never ever be the rightful answer. We are now closer to the end of this documentary. I hope you're enjoying it so far. Anyway, I have done stuff I was not proud of, so what is this topic even about? Well, this is what it's all about. Two accounts. One of them being a fake one. The first fake account I have made was Cody2. If you don't know what I'm talking about, Cody is the person that uploaded Level Easy and was really popular by likes and downloads. Now I created the account Cody2 to comment on Level Easy that I am the real Cody and to know where I'm going to be. People thought Cody's account was dead until it became an official account called I Am Cody. I then created an Instagram account for Cody too, and I posted a comment on the account profile to follow me, and people actually started following the Instagram account. I then posted screenshots of in progress levels that were actually going to be official. I was thinking to myself, why am I doing this? I just wanted to see people get fooled and also to see their reactions into thinking I am the real Cody. Soon, I stopped everything. I stopped making the levels, I then abandoned the Cody 2 account, and I left a comment on the profile that ended it all. People were actually confused on why a person would hack Cody 2, you know, the supposed real one. Well, no one hacked it. I was the one who left that comment because I couldn't care to explain on why I made the fake account to fool people. We now move on to the next account. Can you guess what it is? If you don't want to guess, then oh well, right? Well, it's a person that made the Lightning Road, and his name is Timeless Real. You may be asking, what about Timeless Real? He came back and now he's gone? Well, I'm here to answer that for you. That is because I have stolen the account. I have stole the account from a hacker on Twitter that posted a text document forum that showed a bunch of accounts that were in the hacker's control. For example, the hacker showed the username and the password next to the username. I opened the link to the account list and I saw Timeless Real. I knew about the level he made, but I don't know how he was hacked. I remember he had an unofficial account and you can't view his profile, but anyone could have hacked him easily back then. And that's what happened. I then stole the account details, and this was back in 2016. I then entered the details I was logging in with. It then worked. I checked right away to see if the level, the Lightning Road, was in my online level page. And it was. The thing is, the coins were in a level and I wanted to get rid of them because I now own the account. But I was like, nah, I'll leave the level as is. Remember, I'm not the one who hacked Timeless Real, but I'm the one who stole the account. Why did I do this? Because I wanted to make sure the hacker doesn't have any more control of it. I also wanted to own it as well, and to make sure someone like me can take good care of it and not destroy it. Also, because he had a popular level back in the day. I then commented on the profile that I would make a sequel to the Lightning Road, but it never happened. Now, why did I post the buy comment after the anticipation of the sequel to the Lightning Road? People were wondering, why did you do that? This has been in my mind ever since I played Geometry Dash. I wanted to end things the way I wanted it to be. First, I wanted to have a rated level, regardless of feature. It came true. Second, I wanted the UFO I currently have so badly. I earned it. And third, I wanted to reach my 100th demon. Now, I knew this marked goal was coming sooner than I expected it to come. I wanted to achieve my 100th demon at least before school started. Now, I was practicing my 100th demon in July 2017, and it was originally going to be Heartbeat. Since I reached a good score, why not keep going more? I said to myself that this level was going to hurt my finger even more, because I want to tell you a story. When I was working with my dad, I put my index finger, the one I played Geometry Dash with, into the hole of the Luber because we were making them back in June 2017. I was then holding it for my dad. He pulled it towards him, and slash. My tip side finger was slashed. Blood was actually dripping on the floor, and it was the most painful moment ever in my life. More painful than levels I have raged on.
No!
I was holding it in. my tears. It wasn't my dad's fault. He warned me not to put my fingers inside the holes of the luber. It was mainly my fault for this. I didn't have to get stitches, thank God. It wasn't a deep slash, but it is now a scar after almost a whole year has passed. I knew this was going to affect me for my 100th demon to beat, because I play with my index finger that was slashed at work. Could I still be my 100th demon? Well, no, because it would put more pressure on my index finger whenever I spam with it or press way harder with it. I would have to do that in order to finish Heartbeat, my 100th demon. I then made an Instagram post to let people know that it was cancelled. I told my followers the reason why I couldn't do it anymore. I really wanted to beat it so badly, but I knew it wasn't going to be finished ever since I accidentally slashed my index finger. I then tried my best to look for a demon level that I had planned before Heartbeat, but didn't have the skill at the time. I then found the level, and it's called The Ultimate Face. I knew this was going to kind of hurt, but not as much. I then started to practice it, and after so many fails, I have done it. At the moment I have beaten this level, my reaction was through the roof. This was counted as the final goal in my Geometry Dash legacy. After I have beaten my 100th demon, my plan was to quit playing Geometry Dash because before, I made a promise to God that I would never ever play the game again after my addiction to it. It was good because I completed my 100th demon the day before school was going to start, and it came true. That was one of the reasons why I quit playing the game. Also, because it was getting boring to me and didn't want to play anymore. Not only just because I made a promise to God, but before I was starting to beat levels, I knew I wanted to quit someday. Now, I made that comment on Timeless Reel, the bye comment, was because I quit playing the game after I have beaten my 100th demon and wanted to end it that way. Notice how I made those comments the same month and year after I've quit Geometry Dash. I don't know what to do with the Timeless Reel account. I don't trust no one with the account because the person I give it to will probably ruin it. I'm thinking if I should just leave it as it is, or continue the account. I honestly don't know what to do with it. I'll figure out a way. Well, I'm sorry for what I have done in the past. I hope you will forgive me. If not, it's okay. I know that it was dumb, but I promise to change.